Now, first up, what we are looking at is a statement which has been released by the Al-Qaeda. Now, this is a statement that can trigger fresh worries, not just for India, but for the entire region. Now, Al-Qaeda has in fact reacted to the Taliban takeover in Afghanistan and called for liberation of Kashmir and other Islamic lands while congratulating the Taliban for what they called a victory in Afghanistan. In a detailed statement issued by Al-Qaeda just hours after the Taliban declared full independence in Afghanistan, the terror group Al-Qaeda referred to its long-standing call for the so-called liberation of regions such as Palestine, the Levant, Somalia and Yemen. So the Al-Qaeda statement of course triggers fresh concerns definitely for India, but also for the first time since the takeover of Afghanistan, as we know that the Indian government in fact held talks with Taliban yesterday, the safe and early return of Indians stranded in Afghanistan was the focus of the conversations that Indian government had with the Taliban representatives. The meeting was between Indian ambassador to Qatar and the head of Taliban's political office in Doha. Now, Indian government also raised concerns of Afghanistan's soil being used for anti-India activities and terrorism. The Indian government added that the Taliban representatives assured that the issues will be positively addressed. Let me go across to Mr. Ashok Sajjanaa, former diplomat, who's joining us over the phone line. Mr. Sajjanaa, thank you so much for speaking to us here on Mirror Now. But what we can in fact see is that there are two developments which have taken place. Of course, the Indian government engaging with the Taliban formally after their takeover in Afghanistan. And now that the Al-Qaeda has in fact issued a statement specifically talking about Kashmir and calling for the liberation of Kashmir. Now, Indian government would of course hope that they will be able to have some sort of a working tie-up with a political understanding with Taliban going forward in terms of them taking over Afghanistan now. But what do you think should be the main challenge that India focuses now that Taliban have in fact in a few days probably are going to form government also, but have officially taken over Afghanistan now that the US troops have gone?
Basic challenges are exactly what our ambassador told Sheikh Stanigzai yesterday when they had the meeting. And that is the priority is for repatriation of our people from there are, I think, about 15 or 20. Most of the people, most of Indians from Afghanistan have already been repatriated. So that is, just about 15, 20 are left. That is the information that I have. So repatriation of those, because we don't want any Indian coming to harm. The second would be in terms of respecting our territorial integrity and sovereignty and not allowing its space to be used for any terrorist acts against India. So that is definitely a very important thing. Of course, we know that there are a large number of groups which have been fighting along with the Taliban in Afghanistan, and Al-Qaeda is one of them, Jaish-e-Mohammed is there, Lashkar-e-Taiba is there. So all of them will carry on their own specific agenda. But we have told the Taliban leadership in no uncertain terms. Taliban might give us a commitment. It might be possible for them to get it enforced, or there might be some difficulty for them. But we have to, since they will be heading the government, it is their responsibility to ensure that nothing of this nature happens against India. Other countries are also, putting down their red lines that their security will not be compromised as a result of the Taliban taking over in Afghanistan, in Kabul. And the third is, of course, that, right. Afghans of Indian origin, Afghan Hindus and Sikhs, if they want to come to India, they will not be stopped from traveling to India.
Right, Mr. Sajjanar, also I wanted to ask you about this Al-Qaeda statement which has now been issued. Of course, at one side they are hailing Taliban and on the other hand they are also calling for liberation of Kashmir. This, of course, adds to fresh worry for India. What do you think that the Indian government should in fact be doing? Should there be some sort of a communication that they make with Taliban at the moment? Because this is clearly going to be a worry, not just for India, but for the entire region.
We have always known it. Yes, you are right. It's going to be a worry for the entire region. And that's why I said different countries have also spoken to the Taliban and are trying to get commitments from them that their security will not be compromised. And of course, terrorist elements in the region, in the neighborhood, are all going to get inspired, will get new energy, will get emboldened and, you know, much greater enthusiasm because they are terming it as, you know, victory of Islam, victory of Allah, that they are fighting evil forces and they have won. So these terrorists should also continue in the struggle. So they will get more energy, they will get more recruits, they will get more funding. So what should India do? What India, exactly what it is doing? You know, it has very significantly improved its counter-terrorism structures, its intelligence grid, its counter-infiltration grid from Pakistan. So we have to be very, very careful, and that is true not only of Kashmir, but of other parts of India, because they can, you know, now mount and launch attacks in other parts of India also. Of course, their focus is going to be on Kashmir, whether it is Al-Qaeda, whether it is Jaish, but we have to be cognizant of the security threat to the rest of the country also, and whether it is our security forces, our intelligence agencies, or our army, they have to be very careful. I think we have made a lot of progress over the last several years. We are quite prepared. We are quite conscious of the threat that has been evident from these groups that have been operating from Pakistan. But of course, they will get new spaces to work from in Afghanistan also. Yes.
That's right. And that is, those are some of the things that the Indian government, as well as other governments from the region, will also be monitoring very closely. Sir, thank you so much for joining us here on Mirror Now on this important conversation.